Five, four, three, two, one.
Lift off. Good morning and welcome to the Berks County Board of Commissioners meeting. This is the first meeting of 2020. It is also the first meeting of the year. And for those of you that believe, and I happen to believe this is the beginning of the new decade, it's the first meeting of the new decade. So please rise for a moment of silence followed by a pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We're going to begin this morning with a special presentation, and I'm going to turn the meeting over to our county controller, Sandy Graffius, to explain what this is about.
In the world of accounting, we have our audit team, and I'd like to introduce them first of all, and then I'm going to introduce Dan Quill, if you want to go over one. Our manager of that department is Oliver Arthur, and then we have Kathy Dietrich, and then we have Candace Roman, and then we have Drew, who we had to work on getting him to smile for the pictures beforehand. And then we have Aaron Hank. And I'd like to introduce Dan Aquila, who is from Lehigh, and he will tell you what this award is all about.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, Commissioners, Controller Graffius, members of the Berks County Controller's Office, and the citizens and employees of Berks County. My name is Dan Aquilino, and I am an auditor for the County of Lehigh, based in Allentown, Pennsylvania. I am here today on behalf of ALGA, the Association of Local Government Auditors, to present a certificate of compliance to the Board of Commissioners and the Controller's Office. The Berks County Controller's Office has opted to follow the United States Government Accountability Office's auditing standards, which is commonly referred to as the Yellow Book, as the guidelines in which their audits are performed. One of their requirements in the Yellow Book is to have your organization reviewed on a regular basis by members outside of the organization to ensure that they are following the standards set within the book. These reviews are called peer reviews. The Berks County Controller's Office had their first peer review this past September after adopting the Yellow Book standards in 2016. Generally speaking, the peer reviews are only required once in any three-year period. Since this was their first peer review since their inception, the office chose a one-year period to be reviewed. As one of the reviewers on this assignment, I would like to present this certificate of compliance to the Berks County Controller's Office and the Board of Commissioners and congratulate them on a job well done. Thank you.
They're just all very serious about their job. Thank you, staff. I appreciate a job well done, and thank you for coming down from Lehigh.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sandy, and the audit staff from the Controller's Office. Congratulations on the certificate of recognition.
Good work.
A couple other items I want to touch on before we go into our agenda. First of all, I'd like to recognize Commissioner Michael Rivera. He is the newest member of the Board of Commissioners and the first new commissioner since we took office back in 2008.
Now he's the youngest one.
Well, that's not surprising.
But I do appreciate the hairline. I do appreciate the look. So.
Yeah.
Now you can't pick on me.
That's true. If I pick on somebody without hair, I'm in the minority.
That's right.
But welcome. Very glad to have you on board. I'm glad looking forward to the term. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you want to make any comments now or at the end.
At the end. We'll
okay. Do it. Yep. Very good. Another individual we want to recognize, which even stacks the odds against me more on the issue of the look, is our newest member of our planning department and our newest director, David Hunter. David, if you want to step up to the mic, just a couple brief words, but we're very, very excited to have you on the Berks County planning team and leading the team.
Good morning, commissioners, good morning, elected David. Officials, appointed officials. Thank you so much. I am honored to serve. I count it a privilege to lead a great team of staff upstairs. The planner's role is to collaborate, and we're going to do just that. I believe in excellence. I believe in implementing best practices, and I'm looking forward to hearing from the commissioners and moving forward, working with the entire county and certainly with the new mayor in Reading, Eddie Moran. Thank you so much.
Well, we're very glad to have you on board.
Yes.
A comment on the hair that my dad reminded me of many years ago that you'll appreciate. He said, when God made man, he was very fair. To some he gave brains, the others hair.
Ah, I like that.
And we're putting you to work already this afternoon for our budget meeting.
Absolutely.
Talk about the comp plan.
Absolutely. We'll be there front and center, and we look forward again to working with you just to move the agenda forward.
Sounds good.
So, thank you so much.
Welcome,
thank you,
David. We're
welcome.
Excited to have
appreciate
you.
It. Amen. Thank you.
And I was going to share this at the end, but I'm since we're talking about people that are new with the county and key leadership positions, I want to announce that we have hired an assistant administrator for the Berks High. This is something we've been discussing actually towards the end of last year. Commissioner Barnhart, myself, and to a degree, Commissioner Scott looked at this. This is through Complete Health Resources. The individual is Christy Kennedy. She has all the certifications. What's very exciting, she worked her way up in the nursing home business in Lancaster County, in the Lancaster County Nursing Home, when it was still a county facility, really from the bottom all the way through. She understands the industry very well. The reason for this decision is that Terry Brennan, our current Berksheim administrator, also a CHR employee, announced that he is retiring in April of next year. And we felt that it was important that we have two things. One, that we make sure we have somebody in position that is highly qualified to take that leadership position. The Berksheim's an important facility. We've invested a lot in it. I know that the employees do a tremendous job. The volunteers do a tremendous job. We think this sends a very clear statement that this is a clear statement. We believe in the Berksheim on a long-term basis. She's going to be working alongside Terry Brennan for that period of time. I don't know her start date yet, but it will be shortly. So we're very excited to have Christy Kennedy coming on board. When you see her, let her know. And then one other person that I want to recognize, two people, okay, I'm looking.
Mary and Barbara.
Barbara, and I know I have Barbara, but the other, oh, okay, yes, Mary Kozak. Okay, Barbara Lopez is the executive assistant for our new colleague, Michael Rivera. We're very glad to have you. You come to us from Neighborhood Housing Services. So welcome. And then finally, we want to recognize, I have a great executive assistant, but sometimes the sign language I struggle with, and I was struggling with the sign language. It's Mary, oh, it's on my phone, okay, yeah, it should. Mary Kozak is also here for her first meeting. Mary is our recently elected recorder of deeds. Very glad to have her here as part of our row officers group. And we have almost, not quite all, but the ones that normally attend our meeting, all of the normal row office attendees are here.
So you're saying these are the normal row officers?
Yeah, versus the abnormal row officers. That will get me in a lot of, that's something Troutman can run with now. Next time you see our sheriff, let him know that the Commissioner Linebach said he's one of the abnormal.
I'm not really sure if these are the normal ones, but time.
But what is certain, that the longest serving role officer, and I would dare say, well, maybe not the oldest role officer, is Jim Troutman, without a doubt, right? There's no contest. So, welcome. Hopefully, have I covered everyone in the room that's new?
I just want to cover the addition of the deputy administrator at the nursing home is not
sure.
Fully paid for out of the county.
That's correct.
There is a partial payment that's being paid through CHR. That was an arrangement we have because, again, we are paying for Terry as well as their management expertise, and as well we're going to be paying part of her salary. So it's a good working relationship
good
we
point.
Have with CHR.
We're paying 75%, right. They're paying 25%.
Right.
So with that, we'll move into our agenda. Are there any additions or corrections for the December 19th commissioner meeting minutes and December 19th budget and operation meeting minutes, as well as the January 6th, 2020 reorganizational meeting? Hearing none, the meeting minutes will stand as presented. Is there any public comment on specific agenda items? Hearing none, we'll move into the agenda. The first item is an enactment of a county ordinance. We have Peter Edelman here, and I'm going to ask Peter to step up. That's not him?
This is a Brian
Gotcha. Oh, sorry. This is a Gotcha one. It's the beginning of the year, okay? An ordinance of the commissioners. I saw Peter's eyes go up, and he's saying, okay, this isn't the ordinance. An ordinance of the commissioners of Berks County, Pennsylvania, establishing procedures and guidelines for the installation of signal boosters associated with the Berks County Public Safety Radio System. Under the budget department, one item, adopt a resolution authorizing 2019 budget transfers in the amount of $577,399, 2019 appropriations in the amount of the negative $135,957, and 2020 budget transfers in the amount of $56,479 per listing dated January 6th of 2020. We have a number of items listed under Human Resources. Item one, authorize the appointment of Barbara Lopez as Executive Assistant. This is for Michael Rivera. Item two, authorize the appointment of Virginia Burgos. She is the Bilingual HAVA Coordinator for Election Services. Item three, authorize the transfer of Kimberly Santoro, Data Analyst 2, Clerk of Courts, to Judicial Coordinator in Court Administration. Item four, authorize a salary adjustment for Jessica Blauser, Executive Assistant to Commissioner Barnhart. Item five, authorize a salary adjustment for Kay Licey, Executive Assistant to our Chief Administrative Officer, Ron Seaman. Item six, authorize a salary adjustment for Abby Reinhart, Judicial Coordinator, Court Administration. Item seven, authorize promotions effective 1-1-2020 for Assistant District Attorney and Assistant Public Defender departments per the attached promotion memorandum. Item eight, authorize salary adjustments effective 1-1 of 2020 per the attached salary adjustment memorandum. Item nine, authorize the utilization of a temp agency for a financial analyst, budget and finance department. Item B, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the stop loss insurance proposal plan with Nationwide Stop Loss and any and all documents required to complete the application process concerning the Berks County Employee Healthcare Insurance Program. Are we at Peter's item now, right? Item A under commissioners, I'm going to let Peter Edelman talk about that, explain what it is.
Good morning, commissioners.
Good
Thank
morning.
You. I'm here today on behalf of Tower Health. Tower Health is moving forward with a tax-exempt bond financing through the Berks County Municipal Authority. As you know, Tower Health is the parent organization for Reading Hospital, as well as five other acute care hospitals in southeastern Pennsylvania. The proceeds of these bonds are going to be used to restructure certain outstanding tax-exempt debt that was previously issued on behalf of Tower by the Berks County Municipal Authority. The purpose of this approval is to comply with the provisions of the Internal Revenue Code. The United States government has determined that whenever tax-exempt bonds are issued on behalf of a private entity, that before the issuance of those bonds, a public hearing be held to give members of the public an opportunity to ask questions or comment regarding the proposed issuance of bonds. That hearing was held last year in December by the board of the Berks County Municipal Authority. No members of the public attended. Notwithstanding that, we did provide that opportunity for members of the public to attend. Once the hearing is held, we then come before the Board of County Commissioners as the highest elected officials in the county to obtain approval for the financing on behalf of Tower. Again, this is a requirement of the Internal Revenue Code. It's something that we do fairly routinely in front of the Board of Commissioners on behalf of other charitable organizations here in Berks County. The last time we were here was on behalf of Alvernia University. There's a second part of the approval that you have in front of you today, and that is to make a finding that this project is beneficial for the health, safety, and welfare of the people in the county. And of course, given that this is all with respect to the Reading Hospital and the provision of healthcare services, that's a fairly easy finding to make. The other point I want to make is this resolution makes clear that this approval is purely for those two points. This approval does not obligate the county or the taxpayers of the county in any way with respect to this debt. This debt is all on behalf of Tower Health.
What's the total value of the refinancing?
The approval that we're asking today is up to $405 million. So it is a fairly sizable transaction. After this financing, the Tower will only have basically two series of bonds outstanding, a series that you approved in 2017 and now this 2020 financing.
Yeah, and the real essence, just for clarification, is the government doesn't want to approve tax-exempt financing for an initiative that is not viewed in the best interest of a community. And that is the real driver behind this. 2 years ago, and 2 or 3 years ago in the tax reform, we almost lost the ability to do tax-free public financing. And our National Association of Counties, along with the Governor's Association, really fought to keep that because this is the kind of project that it makes sense. We utilize them as well in county government, and it saves taxpayers money.
That's right.
So, very good.
Thank you very much.
Any other questions, comments? Thank you.
Thank you.
Item B under the Commissioners, adopt a resolution of the Berks County Board of Commissioners recognizing the arbitration awards concerning the Berks County Deputy Sheriff's Association and authorizing execution of the awards document. Item C, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving Robert Patrizio, Chief Financial Officer, to bind insurance coverage for Berks County Children and Youth Services effective January 8th of 2020, and further ratifies, confirms, and approves Mr. Patrizio's execution of the general liability and umbrella policy applications. Item D, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the property damage release regarding damage to a county vehicle resulting from an automobile accident. Item E, adopt a resolution approving rules and regulations for public meetings pursuant to the Sunshine Act. Item F, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute the attestation page of the facility recredentialing questionnaire from Aetna for the Berksheim Nursing and Rehabilitation. Item G, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving execution by the chair of the local plan CEO letter and the WIOA plan review and modification form for the Berks County Workforce Development Board's review of the Berks County program year 2017 through 19, Workforce Innovation and Opportunity Act, multi-year local area plan. Item H, adopt a resolution authorizing the Berks County Board of Commissioners execution of a letter of support for Berks Connections pretrial services for a grant application for PA Smart funding from the Pennsylvania Department of Labor and Industry. The grant funding is to enhance enrollment to those programs and or increase the number of individuals entering registered apprenticeships for the Rebuilding Reentrance and Reading, the R3 program. Item I, adopt a resolution authorizing execution of the First Amendment to Management Services Agreement between the County of Berks and Complete Healthcare Resources Eastern Inc. to provide the appointment of an assistant administrator at the Berksheim, subject to final review and approval by the solicitor's office. Item three, a motion authorizing execution of contract agreements and amendments as furnished by the contract coordinator as set forth on the attached listing dated January the 7th of 2020. There are a total of 16 contracts. There are two with Children and Youth Services. There's one jointly with Children and Youth Services and Juvenile Probation. There are two with Court Administration. There's one with the Department of Emergency Services, one with Election Services, one with Facilities and Operations, two with Human Resources, one with Information Systems, three with the Berks County Jail, one with the Parks and Rec Department, and one with the Berks County Library System. And then finally, a motion to ratify and confirm payments as set forth on the Comptroller's Office voucher listing. It's dated January the 7th of 2020 for the week ending January 8th of 2019. That should be 20. That's okay. 2020, and the payment of electronic transfers and employee payroll. That's been signed and is with our chief clerk.
Motion to approve the agenda is presented.
Second.
The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion is carried. And we'll turn now to our county treasurer, Dennis Adams, for the treasurer's report.
Well, good morning, 2020, huh?
Morning.
Good morning.
I couldn't believe when the calendar flipped to 1980. Where did 40 years go?
1980.
You were just a young pup.
Yeah, I was.
We have an opening balance today of $157,970,616.34. A balance to clear of $3,867,556.27. Leaving us with a balance of $154,103,060.07.
Very good. And our county controller, Sandy Graffius, with the controller's report.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Just because of the way the holidays landed this year, I have three reports. I have one for Christmas week, I have one for New Year's week, and I have one for today. So get set. We'll start with...
There's going to be a test when they're done. We will be able to randomly choose from the audience. If you fail, we'll figure out what we'll do.
I'll make it quick. All right, first we'll do a disbursement for the week ending 12/24. Total accounts payable, $5,407,983.72. See how quickly we're going to work.
No, that was fast. Okay, I'm good.
Okay, 31st. Total accounts payable, $9,706,689.91. Now then, we'll get to the press.
The details,
yeah,
for this
we'll
week.
Get to the details. By the way, it was interesting to get the work out because a lot of people keep their vacations till the end of the year, and with the holidays falling the way it did on a Wednesday, we were real short staffed, but the ones that did get in worked their little fingers to the bone, and we just got all the checks out like they were supposed to. And thanks to the treasurer's office, you were doing your piece to get them out there too. We create it, and he takes care of getting them out to people. Total accounts payable, $7,303,336.71. We had a payroll this week, $4,384,518, for a grand total of $11,687,855.36. And that is bring us up to date with all of our housekeeping.
Very good. And we'll turn now to our Chief Financial Officer, Bob Patrizio, for the agenda for this afternoon's budget and operations meeting.
Good morning, Commissioners. Good morning. We do have a meeting today. It starts at 2 p.m. There are two items on the agenda. One you mentioned earlier, our comprehensive plan discussion with members of our planning department and our new director.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you so much.
And I believe our assistant solicitor is in that meeting too, right?
Yes. And then also a discussion of the jail next steps.
Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you. And we'll turn now to our Chief Administrative Officer, Ron Seaman.
Thank you, Mr. Linebacker. I have nothing.
Okay. Commissioner Barnhart.
Actually, I wasn't ready for that. Okay. Thank you, Commissioner Linebacker. A couple of quick items. I first want to thank Bern Township supervisors as well as their manager. We attended their meeting Monday evening regarding the transfer of Epper School from a property owned by Greater Berks Development Fund to our Heritage Center, and they were pleasantly willing to waive the land development plan, which really would have had to lag into February till their planning commission met. And we do believe that they're also going to waive our stormwater requirements. So hopefully we can move the school within this calendar month, and then of course Greater Berks Development Fund can move on with their development plan. So I want to thank Bern Township for their willingness to give us that waiver. Mount Pemp Preserve. We are having an exciting meeting today, our marketing and promotion committee. We're looking at Music on the Mountain. It won't be this year, but hopefully next year, to really kind of partner with various musical groups around the county, because we've become a real mecca for music. We have the Country Music Fest, Jazz Fest, Blues Fest, and we think this could really be a several-day event on the mountain at all the venues. The Pagoda, the Tower, Drenkel Field, our park as well, and really make it a festive way for people to really enjoy and explore Mount Penn. So more details to follow. We had a real positive meeting with the Greater Running Trails Partnership at Berks Nature the other day. They've been in existence for 15 years, focusing on all the trails in Berks County, but they have kind of avoided Mount Penn because of all the jurisdictions that are impacted, five to be exact. In Mount Penn, and now that we have the Mount Penn Preserve, there's a coordinated effort, because obviously Mount Penn Preserve consists of an elected official and an appointed official of each of those municipalities in the county. So we're going to be meeting as a part of their organization to really figure out the trails, the ones that are vitally necessary for recreation and the ones that have been put in illegally. And our goal is to sign all these trails and then eliminate the trails that are not supposed to be there. So it was a really good hour and a half meeting. Actually, Bamba has brought forth, which we all embraced, is signs very similar to skiing signs. You know, difficult, more difficult, challenging. And then we had emergency services there as well, getting into the details of these signs should also mark locations for first responders. There obviously are issues with cell phone coverage and things of that nature. So you can certainly tell somebody, help, I need help, I'm on Mount Penn. But it'd be a lot easier if, in fact, you were near a mile mark or a post, and then the first responders could work that out. So a lot of positive things coming out of Mount Penn Preserve. I just thought I'd let the public know that we're moving forward in a positive direction. Thank you.
Very good. Commissioner Rivera.
Yep. You know, first of all, I'd like to congratulate the Controller's Office staff for the work they've done and the recognition they received today. Thank you for your hard work. Looking forward to hearing that the rest of the county employees work hard as well. So congratulations and keep moving forward. All right.
Thank you.
Yes, you're welcome. I also want to welcome David Hunter. I heard a lot of great things while he was at the city. So looking forward to working with him here now at the county. And Mary Kozak, welcome as well.
Thank you.
Okay. And Commissioner Linebacker had introduced my executive assistant, Barbara Lopez. But I want to welcome her. One of the things that was important for me in looking for an executive assistant was that it would be someone that I know and that I trusted, but it would also that it would be someone that is bilingual. Because part of what I want to do is be able to reach out to the Latino community and get them engaged. And Barbara is bilingual. I've known her for many, many years, and she's really engaged in the community as well. So that's why I chose Barbara, and I'm looking forward to working with her. Hopefully, we haven't scared you off yet, Barbara. Okay, great. Also want to thank the staff here on the 13th floor that I've been working with so far, Ron, Mary Jo, Christine, the rest of the staff here made me feel welcome. My two colleagues here have also been there for me. We've had different discussions. They put me up to date on different issues. So I really appreciate that, Bob as well. So it's really been a good first 4 days here in the county. And I'm looking forward to the next 4 years, doing a lot of great things together with my colleagues here and working together with them. I will be in the next few weeks putting together meetings with the department heads, the row officers, learning about how the county operates, what goes on, what the needs are. We'll also be visiting the county facilities to get up to speed with the different facilities that the county has and any issues that there may be with the facilities and how we can help move things forward with that. Also, we'll be meeting with the different staff from our state and federal legislators as well to see how we can form working relationships with them. There's a lot of things that we get done here at the county, but there are other things that we need to get done also in coordination with local, state, and federal elected officials as well. So those are some of my goals within the next week is, you know, getting up to speed with everything that's going on. Yesterday, I had the opportunity to go with Commissioner Linebach to the Pennsylvania Farm Show, and a great opportunity there. I grew up in Puerto Rico. There's not a lot of farming there, so this was something that was new to me. Although on my mother's side of the family, they have farmers in their family, but this was going back many, many years ago when I would come up and visit here during the summers. So it was a great opportunity to get to know our ag community, what goes on, learn more about that. And we also had the opportunity to visit with different farmers and people from the ag community here from Berks County. So I was able to get to meet them, introduce myself to them, and I'll be looking forward to following up with them as well. Understanding that ag is an important part of our county here. So it's a great opportunity for me to be able to get out there and learn a little bit more and educate myself as to one of the important issues here in Berks County. So thank you very much and look forward to working with you.
Yes, Ron.
Just one note, the commissioner opined to how great his first 4 days have been here. You have 1,456 more to go.
And count them on to figure that out. I was going to say, who's counting, but apparently not.
I thought it would have been Bob, but...
No, Bob counts. If it's Bob's money, yeah. Bob counts it. If it's not money, he's not counting.
If it's a dollar sign.
Yeah. He wants to know if you have any money-saving ideas.
Yeah. So, well, thank you very much, and welcome. We're glad to have you, on the team. This marks not only a new year and a new term, but I have to tell you, in the 12 years that I've served, and I'm guessing you probably feel the same way, I've never been more excited about the opportunity to cooperatively work with the city of Reading. Eddie Moran, Mayor Moran, is off to a very, very good start. And I cannot tell you how excited I am with his selection of former Pennsylvania Secretary of the Commonwealth, Pedro Cortez, as the new city managing director. Now, I know he has to be approved by a council, but Pedro Cortez has served under both Republican and Democratic governors. I've known him for a number of years. He's a man of integrity. He has a lot of connections. And I will tell you, just with Mayor Moran, I was looking forward to working with Eddie and his team. But bringing somebody in like Pedro Cortez is a huge win, not just for Reading, but for the whole region. Berks County will benefit by having a man like Pedro. And I asked, I said, you're moving to Reading? I don't know if he has the apartment yet, but he's getting an apartment in Reading. good man. I am very, very excited about the things we can do together. David Hunter and I met, I think the first day you were here, and I knew David from the city as well, and David offers a connection because he ran the city planning department. So there's a lot of good things to look forward to. It doesn't mean the city and the county are going to agree on everything. It doesn't mean we're going to agree on everything. But I'm just excited about this team, and I'm excited about the team that is being put together in the city of Reading. We, all three of us, attended the swearing in. I believe all of us were at the celebration. You weren't. Okay.
I was at Burn Township.
You were at Burn Township.
They made me sit through the whole meeting till the bitter end.
So they didn't let you go to the very end.
They didn't put me. They put me at the bottom. Well, that's okay. I respect that.
If I was chairing the meeting, I would have put you at the beginning.
What are you doing here? Get up in the front.
So very excited, and I wanted to start on that note. That's not something I've been able to say in the last 12 years, and especially in the last two administrations. But this is exciting. A lot of good things to come. The only other thing I want to touch on is the farm show. Yesterday, we took Mary and I, along with Tammy Hildebrand, who is the head of our Berks County Department of Ag, and Commissioner Rivera, went to Harrisburg, and we took three students with us. We had Grace Prout. She is a senior at Ole, and she's also the FFA president. We had Natalie Grumbein from Topahakan. She is also FFA president. And she a junior or senior? She's a senior. She was just accepted at Penn State in the Ag Business program. And then we had Tanner Davis from Schuylkill Valley. He's in the FFA program. He's a junior. But it's kind of scary because several years ago, I had his sister, Michaela Davis, as one of the individuals we took. I think we took her to Ag Progress Days. But this is right around 50 students now that we've been able to take a combination of Ag Progress Days in August and Farm Show in January of each year to Public Officials Day. So they're able to meet. They were able to meet Russ Redding, who is the Secretary of Agriculture. They were able to meet some assistant deans of Penn State University. They got to hear from Scott Seckler. Scott Seckler owns Bell and Evans, the poultry operation. It's based in Lebanon, but Scott Seckler lives here in Berks County up in the Straustown area. I could talk about Scott and the things that he shared with us. Maybe I'll do that some other time. I'm thinking about actually having him on a BC TV show. I will tell you this. He almost dropped out of high school. In 11th grade, he had missed so many days at Hamburg that somebody at the school said to his parents, you know what, you need to decide. Do you want to raise chickens, because that's what he was missing school for, or do you want to graduate from high school? And he said, I'll raise chickens. I'll give up high school. And so Hamburg figured out a way to turn the raising chickens into an ag component, and he graduated from high school but went right into the poultry business. And I will tell you, he is booming. His customers for organic chicken are Wegmans, Giant, Whole Foods. He ships through Amazon all over the country. And I will tell you one other story that just blew my mind. He's looking for people to hire. He doesn't hire based on what you know. He hires based on your passion. And several years ago, he was up at CNC Pizza in Straustown, and he goes up there all the time, and he really liked one of the workers. And he said to them, how would you like to come work for me? That worker decided to come work for him. Started at $10 an hour. He gave us the guy's name. The guy now is one of his lead managers, and in a handful of years, he's making $110,000 a year. Because Scott's looking for people that are passionate. So I learned so much just sitting there, and then all of us were standing around listening, and I forgot Mike Firestein. Mike Firestein is with Fulton Bank. He's a farmer in Western Berks. He took us on the tour. He knows everybody up there. He spent from 9:15 till almost 4 o'clock with us, taking us around. He is vice president of the Farm Show Foundation. He and his wife are very, very involved. We were on WEEU. Mike Firestein helped WEEU get a spot because they waited a little bit too long to get on. And Mary Kozak heard us because you sent a message, I believe, to Michael Rivera while we were on the air. We had all the students interviewed. It was really pretty awesome. One last thing I want to share with you. The public officials luncheon, often it gets fairly boring because you got to listen to politicians. And I'm not saying anything against the politicians, but they did a different program this year. And I think, Mary, it's the best program we've ever heard. They brought entrepreneurs in that presented a PowerPoint of what they are doing in agriculture. And we heard from a company called Farmstead Cheese. They are a small farm, I think maybe 50, 60 cows. And they have figured out how to, instead of selling their milk on the market for $20 a hundredweight, they anticipate, once they're completely done, being somewhere around $80 per hundredweight because they're turning it into cheese on the farm, and they shared their whole model. We heard from Sunshine Distillery up in McKean County. They have found a way to make distilled spirits out of a particular type of sunflower seed. And they are growing acres and acres of sunflower, and their goal is to start a unique area in Pennsylvania that raises hundreds, maybe eventually thousands of acres of sunflowers and becomes a distillery of this brand new type of spirit. They compared it to tequila that comes from a very specific area in Mexico because it has to do with not just the plant but the soils. They have the same situation up in that area. We also heard from Fox Chase Elementary Agricultural School in Philadelphia. Didn't even know it existed. It's an elementary school that is anchored in ag sciences. And every area you could think of, and 20 more areas you never thought of relative to ag, and piquing children's interest that otherwise would never, in a major city, never connect. And the last one was 412 Food Rescue out of Pittsburgh. Does anybody have an idea, or has anyone ever heard of 412 Food Rescue? 412 Food Rescue is based on the scientific study that in the United States, we waste approximately 40% of all food and produce at all different levels, not just the restaurant level. 412 uses a Lyft Uber model of volunteers that are tied by their phones that are part of a network, and a call will go out that a restaurant, a grocery store, whatever, has this amount of produce that they need to move immediately from their location to the necessary Meals on Wheels, whatever it might be. They are moving tons of food in Pittsburgh immediately from the farm, the restaurant, the grocery store, the producer that they can no longer sell it under FDA rules and other rules, but they can get it to people who need it. I was blown away. I share all of that because sometimes people may think, go to the farm show, it's kind of a vacation day. And it is. It's an awesome experience. But it's amazing what you bring back. I'm going to look at 412 possibly for Reading and the greater Reading area. It is in, I think he said, 20 or 30 cities now around the country. I wouldn't have known about that if I hadn't been at the public officials luncheon in Harrisburg yesterday. And I am going to share one last thing that was just encouraging to me. Our youngest son is in northern Iraq. So Tuesday night was a little scary. In the lobby of the farm show yesterday, I saw a whole group of military folks. And I happened to know William, commanding Brigadier General Mike Regan. He is overseas the Pennsylvania Air National Guard. And I walked down and he was standing right there. And so I asked him and he said, "Commissioner, everything's good." He said within seconds of the attack, we were in direct communication with our men and women that are based at, I forget the name of the base, it's the most northern base. He said, everyone's doing great. He said, everyone's going to be fine. I was able to text that back to my wife and to William's wife, and it was encouraging. It was a side benefit that I didn't expect to hear that kind of encouragement. So just wanted to share that with you. You never know what God brings across your path to encourage you, and that was one of the things that I didn't expect, and got to see him and hear the good news and know that our son, while he's in a combat zone, he's safe and doing well. So that's all that I have. Any comments? Well, Mary Kozak, your new row officer, anything you, well, she doesn't have a microphone.
That's okay. I think my voice will carry.
Here, it won't carry for BCTV. Here, just, we'll bring this right over. We're good, Tyler. Jordan, I'm sorry, Jordan.
Well, commissioners, I want to thank you. I want to thank everyone here in the courthouse that have been coming to visit our office, and my personnel, my fellow staff members are very impressed by everyone coming in. I guess they haven't had that for 12 years. Mm-hmm. And I really appreciate it. And I thank everyone that has been so kind. We have, 1,900 employees. And I think the best thing that happened to me is from Bob's office. I walked in the door and one of his employees said, "Happy first day." Mm-hmm. And so these 4 days have been, they've been overwhelming in a good way. I am humbled and I am honored. And it truly is, it's an experience to serve and it's a privilege, and I will not take advantage of that. I give you my word. Thank you.
Thank you, and welcome.
Thank you.
Any other comments from a row officer? Sandy.
Well, Christian, Commissioner Leinbach was talking about the combination of the city and the county working together. We had a young lady in our department, in our audit staff, named Maria Rodriguez, and she was just elected to be the city auditor.
That's correct.
And she called me and said that she was going to reinstitute the audit committee for the city of Reading and asked me to serve on the audit committee, so I'll be checking on the city's budget. I am delighted and boggled at the same time.
Another good signal. Dennis.
Well, since I found out a little earlier that I'm normal.
Jury's still out.
Depends who you talk to.
I think of the young Frankenstein movie, Abby Normal.
You know? Yeah, I know exactly, yes.
I'd just like to congratulate everybody who got elected, Mary and Michael, and appointees. I think that'll be great for the group. I'd like to thank the auditors. As an old auditor, that's a very thankless job, tough job to do, because nobody wants to see the auditors walk in. But they do a very fine job, because I kind of look over their shoulders, and they don't know it, but Sandy has me looking. So. Great job, guys.
Dennis looks over my shoulder at times, too, so yeah, don't feel bad. Yeah. Very good.
We use Dennis as a resource when we're going to be looking at his programs.
Good. He has a lot of experience. And you're not an old auditor, you're seasoned.
Seasoned.
Okay, any public comment?
Motion to adjourn.
Meeting is adjourned.
I tell you, it was caught me off guard seeing. We'll be right back.